Hello, friends and family. Let's have a talk. So, recently I learned that I am incredibly controlling. And I would never think of myself in that way. Like, I never think that I was controlling or I had a desire to control everything. I thought I was a very happy-go-lucky, go-with-the-flow type of girl. But I am incredibly controlling. And that is something that I've noticed a lot in other people as well who are self-aware, that they also realize how controlling they are. And it's very difficult because having the desire to control everything has bled into my relationships with people, and most importantly, my relationship with myself and my relationship with God. It's like there is really a lot that I cannot control, and there is a lot that I have a desire to control. However, because my desire to control certain things is so far suppressed in my system, I don't even realize, like, I don't take it as a control issue at face value. I take it as fear or just discomfort or anxiety rather than a control issue. And it's very hard. So I have a control issue, and I want to not be so controlling.
Hi, my name is Jade Marie Whitaker. We're already off on a great foot.
This is the hard part.
Oh,
I have to do this foot now, and it's like, oh my gosh. But at least I'm using my dominant hand to do it. My fingers. So. And yes, this is free feet content. If you would like to pay for my feet, send me how people do that. And I might start something. A little foamy fans, if you get what I mean. A little foamy fans. I just watched this movie. Actually, that's what we did partly on the first date. Watched this movie where this girl did like OnlyFans. They called it 18 plus. Ashley Benson is the one who directed it. But
you?
Oh fuck. Well, this is my new song, Glenn Hirst. I'm doing it right now. Yeah, it's interesting because it's completely a cappella, right? I'm recording it, me and my cat at like 4 a.m. So, that's it. My friend, she was just like, drop it. It's like, 2023, interesting actually. I love that.
Usually I make vision boards for my birthday or vision boards for a certain like astrological event, but no, this one's just vision. And it's funny because I've been super duper intentional with each and every post. Been posting and I've been super duper intentional about this board as well. But even down to intention, there's an aspect of needing control over the certain things that you are hoping to blossom, you know. But every seed that you plant does reap something, and this video is a seed of me planting an acknowledgement of my growth and also an acknowledgement of how far I need to continue to grow. It's hard out here for a pimp. It really is. Today I got a little bit sad. And it's funny because it's overcast and I tend to get a little bit gloomy when the weather does as well. And I don't necessarily know the reasons why. And at the same time, I take on a lot of energy, but I don't necessarily believe or think that the people around me are gloomy as well. But when I tell you almost every time it gets overcast or it feels like it's about to rain, I feel like I'm about to rain too. And not rain in the sense of kingship, but rain in the sense of I'm going to cry. And oftentimes I don't necessarily cry, but I do get sad. And it's kind of hard because it rains often. But yeah, I just wanted to share a little bit about myself and hopefully it brings somebody some peace, because y'all have been reaching out to me sharing how I've been able to share some light in your lives, which has been very encouraging to me. And I really do hope that this continues to just grow and blossom to be a space where people can learn how to be more confident in themselves and more confident in their feelings, because I feel a lot, I speak a lot, and some people take that for granted, and it's really a blessing that I have.
When y'all don't be wanting to brush your teeth all the way, do you just use mouthwash and then brush your teeth with mouthwash? Because I brushed my teeth this morning, but I did have some kava earlier, so I'm like...
You see this bug?
It ain't no backwoods on this side of town. So... Do you have any affirmations for the
I am light. Mm-hmm. In terms of like being light as a feather, but also I am light as in being a source of light.
That's
I'm a beam of light.
Ellie?
I am healthy. I am wealthy. I am pretty. I'm walking it. I'm not interested.
We are two. Basically, girl, so he was talking to other girls throughout our relationship, and not the whole time, but towards the end, because he did the whole I want this to end, but I'm not going to tell you that I want it to end, but I realized that I want it to end, so I'm just going to act despicable and hope you end it, which is what he did. And it hurt me a lot because I care for him so, so, so much. But I had a lot of epiphanies after the relationship ended, because I gave him my all and then some. Like, dude, I gave him more than I even realized that I could give somebody. And you know, it wasn't that long after, but even me and him in our relationship, like, it ran its course. Like, towards the end of it, we were just kind of on the same vibe of like, this isn't working out, but we had the adult conversation of like, we're gonna be friends after this, like, this isn't like, we don't want to have a bad breakup. But with this guy, it was a bad breakup. And like, I've never been heartbroken like how I've been heartbroken, but after I was aware of how he played me, it kind of set me free, because it was like, it feels like I was so caught up, and he potentially could have never loved me a second of that. You know what I mean? So that's what happened.
Good morning. I've silenced 3 alarms. It is 6:21. We're about to get in the shower. I'm probably gonna sleep in the car.
So I am on the way to my friend Natalie's house. I think it's best for me to get out the house, get around some peers, you know? So that's what we're going to do. And I'm excited. I haven't seen her in a minute. She just took a trip, so I'm excited.
When it comes to control in school, like, I'm going over to Nat's house right now, and I know she's gonna be writing a paper.
The thought of writing a paper is so nerve-wracking, because I haven't written a, like, academic paper for a grade in, like, 3 years. And my mom's in school right now, and I just watch her sit up all night doing her homework, and I'm just like, Lord, bless me. But I'm going back because I have a calling and I have a purpose there. Point blank, period. But I'm a little bit daunted by the academic accomplishments that are going to be over my head. But I know that I'm trusting God with it for sure, and just as I said, I have a purpose and a calling here. In addition to that, I know that one of the things, so I've talked about my mental health on here before, and
I started school this fall, and it's kind of something that has been out of all.
When I was a freshman in college,
going back and forth about where I'm going, where I desire to write the fucking paper.
So I took
three hours. I go back. I'm a little bit nervous.
And I shouldn't have done that, because it
stirred my brain. And yeah.
What it would be like to see my ex, and he's in a new relationship now.
Just kidding. But I thought of what it would be like to, like, be in his presence again. And, girl, I don't even know. And that's a situation that I don't have control over. But I'm very composed. Like, I'm very poised. I keep it classy. I stay graceful. So I know it wouldn't be anything detrimental. But he kind of fucking ruined my heart a little bit. Just a tad. And I'm building myself back up. But I didn't even have control over that. And it's like, I was talking to my friend earlier today about intuition. And for y'all who love astrology, I'm a Cancer moon. I have a lot of Cancer placements. So I'm like, Jesus, Lord. I don't like those cars that just release black emissions. Like, I'm an environmentally conscious girl. So every time I see that, it hurts my heart a little bit. But, intuition. It's like, you would think that I have a strong suit in intuition. Like, I'm an intuitive queen. And I am. But when it comes to my decision making and my actions and my habits and my principles and my practices, I feel like my intuition kind of lags a bit and doesn't have the strongest influence over the decisions that I make. And that kind of sucks, because it's like, damn, like, I knew that I was getting into an environment where I could end up having my heart, like, broken, but I didn't think I was gonna have my heart ripped to shreds like I did. Like, and what's crazy is, I can't even go there. But anyways, Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Hi, I'm on the way.
Okay.
Okay. Bye, I love you.
Go past this light. Where is the next one? Turn left.
Dang, this book just took a massive turn.
Stay in the right two lanes. My purpose is serving my children, and I'm ready to help.
So another thing, I had a personal trainer for a while, and that was one of the happiest moments of my life, because I was getting physically fit, I was getting trained, it was great, and I want that again. And when I was talking to my friend earlier today, one of the things that he brought up was working out, and that's something that I do have control over, but I visualize it in a specific way. Like, I'm not a workout girly. I don't set workout plans for myself. At least I haven't in the past. And what I believe works best for me is a personal trainer. Personal trainers are muy, muy. So it's like, I'll get there when I get there, because I was there, so I am there. It's just like, I want it. And also, I can develop a little bit of discipline, do it for myself, and only have to pay for a gym membership, but we'll see.